Thank you very much, thank you very much. Now Sri Vijay Sai Reddy.
Sir, thank you, Deputy Chairman, sir. Sir, this NABARD 2000 Amendment 2017 bill envisages an additional inflow of capital of more than 25,000 crores. Sir, I have carefully perused the bill. It is only an enabling provision. It is not a mandating provision. I hope the MOS Finance, who is sitting here, will come back to this house with an appropriation bill from the present budget itself to the extent of more than 25,000 crores, though it is inadequate, to meet the agrarian crisis that plagues India. So you will have to come back. It is an enabling provision. I am repeating, it is an enabling provision, and there has to be an appropriation to the extent of more than 25,000 crores, additional 25,000 crores, more than 25,000 crores, as suggested in this bill. Sir, I have four concerns and three suggestions I would like to make in this regard. Sir, I draw your kind attention to the National Sample Survey Organization, which has reported the situation in like this. And it has been reported by the National Sample Survey Organization that the institutional credit has consistently been coming down since 1991 till 2013. So in fact, in 1991, the institutional credit was approximately about 69.4%, whereas it has come down in 2013 to 56%, the fall of approximately about 15% is really sizable, and we are all concerned with that. Alternatively, on the other hand, the non-institutional credit, which was at 30.6% in 1991, non-institutional, that is private money lenders, it has gone up from 30.6% in 1991 to 44%. And the increase in non-institutional funding is really significant. It is really alarming also. Therefore, I request the Government of India to take cognizance of it and increase the institutional funding to the farming sector. Sir, coming to the Andhra Pradesh, I draw your kind attention that the pure tenant farmers of 7.56 lakhs of farm households who are there in the Andhra Pradesh, and owner cum tenant households of 24.37 lakh households, and the total out of total suicides of the farmers, 50% of the farmers who are committing suicides are only tenant farmers. Therefore, you will have to address the problem of tenant farmers also, not only owner farmers. Sir, the second issue, see, my suggestion in this regard is you will have to increase the institutional funding for the farming sector to meet the agrarian crisis. Sir, my second point is increasing indebtedness of the farmers. This is what my observation is. See, the same sample, National Sample Survey Organization, reported the worsening situation of indebtedness of farmers in India. Sir, the indebted farm households in India as of today is about 51.9%. And the indebted farm households in Andhra Pradesh is 93%, whereas when national average is only 51.9%, in Andhra Pradesh, this indebted farm households are to the extent of 93%, so which is very alarming. The average outstanding debt of a cultivator household in Andhra Pradesh is 1.123,000. That is the average indebtedness, so which is really alarming. Why is this indebtedness? This indebtedness is on account of the non-availability of institutional credit, and these farmers are borrowing from the private financiers who are charging exorbitant rates of to the extent of 24 to 28-30%. So this situation has to be addressed. I request the Honorable MOS Finance to address this problem of making the credit available to the farmers. Sir, the third important point, complementing credit with the knowledge dissemination. Sir, in fact, this NABARD has decided to give, I hope the this is what the information what I have collected. NABARD has decided to lend not only to the farmers through banks, but also it has started giving, it started funding the research organizations and also the farmers who are conducting the research also. This has to be complemented, and it's a good thing, and you will have to increase the funding to the research organizations and directly to the farmers who are conducting the research also. This the last point, sir. Highest interest rates. Last point, sir. Highest interest point. Sir, my suggestion, I'm directly coming to the point, sir. The marginal cost of the banks, which are the system which is being followed by the bankers for non-agricultural sector, that is, the marginal cost of funds based lending rate, they call it as MCLR, sir. Adopted by RBI is such a system which forces lenders to readjust their lending rates monthly based on the repo rate changes and certain other parameters.
Okay.
I hope NABARD also would implement the same, and Government of India needs to consider this.
Thank you. I, with
a fond hope that the Minister of Finance would address these problems.
Okay.
I am concluding and supporting this bill also.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Sri Ananda Bhaskar Rappalu.
Respected Deputy Chairman, I salute the grand, great memory of Indira Gandhiji, whose birth anniversary celebrated on November 19. She was the Prime Minister who conceived and enacted in 1981, and she led to establish National Bank for Agriculture and Rural Development with Mumbai as its headquarters in 1982. From then on, the saga of National Bank for Agriculture and Rural Development is the saga of the success, and it has become the household name among the agricultural and rural and cooperative crediting agencies. Then on, in 2011, during UPA government, we have decided to infuse 30,000 crore rupees into NABARD for its strengthening of financial and financing capacities. I appreciate the present government for taking up and initiating to infuse the paid up capital from 5,000 crore rupees to 30,000 crore. But times are changing. Transformation is wide. NABARD is being assigned very many number of variety of tasks. Basically, it has the mandate of refinancing, but wherein it is looking after the health and capacity of the regional rural banks. It is also caretaker of cooperative credit structure and credit revival. Keeping these factors with the additional responsibilities of the financing to finance irrigation and housing projects, we need to have a special focus to save NABARD in its capacity. If we study the health and the capacity of the China National Rural Bank, it is one of the world's largest banks and having the capacity to cater to the budgetary needs of China, wherein this NABARD is not growing on that par. and with that expansion. However, it is the successful story of the NABARD which is having great impact on state government's rural development oriented projects. I have special pleasure and my appreciation is on record to the present government for including handlooms onto the financing responsibility of the NABARD. With the times transition, you are rightly changing the nomenclature from small scale industries, cottage and village industries to micro enterprises, small enterprises and medium enterprises, cottage and village industries and handlooms. I welcome it. We were not having the backup support. Being the son of the weaving community, being the son of the weaving occupation, being the son of the weaving profession, I take extraordinary pleasure for strengthening us, empowering us. Our handloom sector will definitely feel safe with the refinancing support of this NABARD through this enactment. At the same time, I have my apprehension and I re-emphasize that the micro enterprises, the small enterprises, the medium enterprises shall invariably be of the agricultural and rural development and rural enterprise orientation only. Otherwise, it will be going into the hands of the corporates, those who are having the urban and semi-urban orientations.
Now conclude.
Keeping these factors in view, the burden of NABARD to look after 140 regional rural banks and to cater to the needs of cooperative sector, I have one request. Yes, all the states are looking towards NABARD for its support. Likewise, my Telangana state is also looking at for the support of NABARD. I request Union Government and Union Finance Ministry to encourage NABARD to finance as promised to the cleaning of Musi River, which also will give safe water to Hyderabad and its surroundings. Besides that, you are going to finance irrigation projects to the tune of 77,000 crores. From that, 11 projects are from Telangana, for which NABARD has assured to give 7,000 crore.
Okay.
I expect the expeditious decisions and the several projects which are being contemplated by NABARD shall be okay. Agriculture and rural development oriented only. Okay. With this suggestion and advice, I appreciate and welcome and support the bill. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Now, Sri Shiva Pradhan Shukla. Honorable Minister, yes.
Maniu Padakshi ji, Dr. T. Subrayan sahab yahan maujood nahi hai. Unhone vishay ke pravartan ke samay is baat ko kaha tha.
Message ye hai
ki sahakarita ke kshetra mein सहकारिता के क्षेत्र में नवार्ड से भी धन देना चाहिए और शुरू करने के बाद श्री नारायण लाल पंचारिया जी, नीरज शेखर जी, एन गोकुल कृष्णन जी, श्री मनीष गुप्ता जी, श्री प्रसन्नाचार्य, श्री नामनाथ ठाकुर, श्री तपन कुमार सेन जी, श्री वीर सिंह, श्री राम कुमार कश्यप जी, श्री डी राजा जी, श्रीमती रजनी पाटिल, श्री विकास महात्मे, श्री राजीव शुक्ला जी, श्री अनिल देसाई जी, श्री विजय साई रेड्डी जी और श्री आनंद भास्कर रोपलू जी,
सब लोग सपोर्ट किया और
क्या? सभी लोगों ने बिल का सपोर्ट किया
और क्या चाहिए?
और साथ साथ मुझे भी सपोर्ट किया क्योंकि पहली बार मैं रख रहा हूँ.
हमारा पूरा सपोर्ट. या दैट इज अवर डेस्टिनी. बैक बेंचर फ्रंट बेंच जाएगा, फ्रंट बेंचर्स बैक बेंचर्स भी हो जाएगा।
लेकिन वहां के वहां ही रहेंगे,
इधर से उधर भी जाएंगे, उधर से इधर भी जाएंगे, दोनों हो सकता है, इधर से उधर और उधर से इधर हो सकता है।
श्री नीरज शेखर जी ने अपनी बात रखी थी,
आई विल रिमेन हियर,
मैं स्वागत करता हूं। जहां तक उन्होंने एनपीए के संदर्भ में कहा था कि कितना एनपीए नवार्ड का है, चूंकि नवार्ड बैंकों को ही पैसा देकर के विभिन्न माध्यम से चाहे किसान को चाहे एमएसएमई को ही प्रोन्नत करता है, इस नाते उसको पैसा बैंक से लेना है, तो ऐसी स्थिति में उसके एनपीए का कोई सवाल उठता ही नहीं है। जी
बैंकों से उसके पास, नाबार्ड के पास
नहीं आ जाता है धीरे धीरे, अब तो इसी नाते और कर दिया गया है कि
किसान बैंकों को रूरल बैंक को देता होगा तो उससे नाबार्ड को आ जाता है, किसान देता होगा तभी।
मैं आप, मैं किसान की तरफदारी के लिए जो आप कह रहे हैं उसके साथ हूं। अध्यक्ष जी, बात इसकी आ रही थी कि कोऑपरेटिव सेक्टर को कितना दिया है, तो कोऑपरेटिव सेक्टर को एलटीआरसीएफ में 15,000 करोड़ और एसटीआरसीएफ में 45,000 करोड़ रुपए दिया गया है, और इधर भी प्रधानमंत्री जी ने भी अनाउंस किया था एडिशनल 20,000 करोड़ रुपए देने का। प्रधानमंत्री अपनी नीति को जिस प्रकार से लोगों के बीच ले जा रहे हैं और ये कह रहा है कि जब यहां शंका एक बात की गई कैसे होगा, तो उन्होंने इस बात को कहा कि हम किसान की आय दोगुनी करेंगे, तो निश्चित रूप से आप विश्वास करिए कि किसान की आय 2022 तक की स्थिति में वर्तमान सरकार जो आगे भी चलेगी ही वह दुगुनी करेगी, इसकी कोई वो नहीं है कि दुगुनी ना हो। अब इस पर तो पहले बहस कर लीजिए, उसके बाद वो भी बताएंगे कैसे होगी। राजीव शुक्ला जी ने एक बात कही थी जिसको मैं स्पष्ट करूं, आरबीआई का नवार्ड में 3 डायरेक्टर्स हैं और उनका एक आशंका यही थी कि कहीं अभी तो रेगुलेटरी अथॉरिटी आरबीआई थी, कल को क्या होगा, इसका कौन होगा, तो यह मैं विश्वास दिलाना चाहता हूं कि रेगुलेटरी अथॉरिटी जो है ऑलरेडी आज भी आरबीआई है नवार्ड की, उसको कहीं हटाया नहीं गया है, इस नाते संरक्षण में देखरेख में वो पूरी तौर पर चलती रहेगी। अभी आरआईडीएफ के अंतर्गत अनौर इसकी चर्चा हुई थी, सरकार अधिक राज्य सरकारों को उपलब्ध करा रही है, जो कई सरकारों ने अपनी इस बात की चर्चा किया है, इन लोगों ने कहा कि आंध्र प्रदेश को और जगह दिया जाए। 2014-15 में 19,666 करोड़, 15-16 में 23,510 करोड़ और 16-17 में 25,600 करोड़। जब मनीष गुप्ता जी साहब बोल रहे थे तो उन्होंने इस बात का विशेष उल्लेख किया था, और इस तरह से केंद्र सरकार ने राज्यों को सहायता हमेशा उपलब्ध कराने का काम दिया। एक सबसे बड़ी आशंका थी, कई लोगों ने इसकी आशंका व्यक्त किया कि नवार्ड के कैपिटल को कहीं प्राइवेट शेयर होल्डिंग को तो करने का वो नहीं है, तो इससे आश्वस्त रहिए कि इस प्रकार का कोई भी प्रस्ताव सरकार ने नहीं किया है और अपने पास उसको पूरा रखा, कहीं भी नहीं किया है। नवार्ड जैसे था वैसे ही है, केवल किसानों के हित को देखते हुए, एमएसएमई के हित को देखते हुए सरकार ने उसके राशि को बढ़ाया है, शेयर को बढ़ाया है। और एक बात और हो रही थी कि 30,000, यह 30,000 अंतिम नहीं है,
यह भी कहा गया था कि आरबीआई से फिर उस पर बातचीत करके वो 50,000 करोड़ तक का हो सकता है, उससे आगे का भी हो सकता है। इतना मतलब यह है। तो स्वाभाविक रूप से ये जो बिल आप लोगों ने लिया, जिसका सभी लोगों ने समर्थन किया है, मैं समझता हूं कि किसान के हित में है, एमएसएमई के हित में है और राज्यों के भी हित में है। राज्य भी इससे लाभान्वित होंगे, चाहे सिंचाई की परियोजना हो, चाहे अन्य, जैसे पंचरिया जी, नारायण पंचरिया जी जब कह रहे थे तो उनके जो उद्देश्य किए थे तो उसे, तो इस सब में कहीं कहीं पूरी तौर पर वो मदद करने का काम करेगी। मैं एक बार पुनः आप सभी लोगों से आग्रह करता हूं कि जो जो छोटे छोटे शंकाएं थी, छोटी छोटी शंकाएं थी, उसको मैंने दूर करने का प्रयत्न किया है। और आप लोगों ने तो बहुत विद्वान वित्त मंत्री पाया है, कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है, आगे और ठीक हो जाएगा। मैं आप लोगों से चाहता हूं कि बिल्कुल पास।
ओके, नाउ थैंक यू ऑनरेबल मिनिस्टर।
उसके बारे में मंत्री जी ने नहीं कुछ कहा।
ठाकुर साहब,
मंत्री जी,
मैंने
आपके हाथ नहीं है तो लिखिए,
इतनी राज्यों को इतना हर साल में,
मंत्री जी
उसमें बिहार भी है।
मंत्री जी आपके पास डिटेल्स नहीं है तो लिखिए, उनके लिए लिखिए, बस
ठीक है,
बैठिए। नाउ क्वेश्चन इज दैट नेशनल बैंक फॉर एग्रीकल्चर एंड रूरल डेवलपमेंट अमेंडमेंट बिल 2017 एज पास बाय लोकसभा बी टेकन इनटू कंसीडरेशन। दोस इन फेवर प्लीज आई, दोस अगेंस्ट प्लीज से नो। I think the ayes have, the motion is adopted. We shall now take it by close consideration of the bill. Close two stand part of the bill. There is one amendment, number one by Dr. Subbaraman Reddy. He is absent. Absent there. I shall now put close two to vote. Those in favor, please say aye. Those against, please say no. I think the ayes have, close two is adopted. Close three and four stand part of the bill. Those in favor, please say aye. Those again, please say no. I think the ayes have, close 3 and 4 are adopted. Close 5 stands part of the bill. There are 5 amendments. Numbers 2 to 4 by Dr. Subbaraman Reddy is absent. Numbers 7 and 8 by Sri K.K. Ragesh. Are you moving? You are moving? Okay, your amendment moved. Eh?
Sir, I moved the amendment because I feel... Yes, I know that the central bank RBI is a regulator, but at the same time it frames credit policies, and that ensures the credit goes to the priority sector, especially the agriculture and agriculture cooperative, SME, etc. And I feel that there should be a proper liaison by the NABARD with the government of India and also RBI, and that is why I am moving this amendment.
So,
and also,
so you are moving,
and also why 51%? Why should not 100%? Okay. There should be 100% share on the part of the central government.
That so you are moving.
Thank you, sir.
Yes, I shall now put the amendment moved by Sri K.K. Ragesh to vote. Those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Those against, please say no.
No.
I think the no survived, the amendments are negative. I shall now put clause 5 to vote. Those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Those against, please say no. I think the ayes have, clause 5 is adopted. Clauses 6 and 7 stand part of the bill. Those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Those against, please say no. I think the ayes have, clauses 6 and 7 are adopted. Clause 8 stand part of the bill. There is one amendment, number 5 by Dr. Subbaraman Reddy. He is absent and so not moved. I shall now put clause 8 to vote. Those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Those against, please say no. I think the ayes have, clause 8 is adopted. Clause 9 stand part of the bill. There is one amendment, number 6 by Dr. Subbaraman Reddy. He is absent. I shall now put clause 9 to vote. Those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Those against, please say no. I think the ayes have, clause 9 is adopted. Clause 10 to 13 stand part of the bill. Those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Those against, please say no. I think the ayes have, clauses 10 to 13 are adopted. Clause 1 stand part of the bill. There is one amendment, number 9 by Sri Shiva Pradhap Shukla. Aapka amendment. Move kar dijiye.
Amendment.
Amendment moved. Those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Those against, please say no. I think the Ayushravidya amendment is adopted. I shall now put clause 1 as amended to vote. Those in favor, please say aye.
I move the bill.
Those against, please say no. I think the Ayushravidya clause 1 as amended is adopted. The enacting formula and the title stand part of the bill. Those in favor, please say aye. Those against, please say no. I think the Ayushravidya enacting formula and the title are adopted. Shri Pradhan Shukla to move.
I move the bill.
No.
I move the bill as amended passed.
Ah, yes. Thank you. Motion moved that the bill as amended be passed. The question is that the bill as amended be passed. Those in favor, please say aye. Those against, please say no. I think the bill as amended is passed. So, thank you. Two bills have been passed. Today we passed two bills. Last day also we passed two bills. Very constructive. Very constructive. Yeah. I think. Message from Lok Sabha.
Sir, I rise to report that the Lok Sabha at its sitting held on the 2nd January 2018 passed the Ancient Monuments and Archaeological Sites and Remains Amendment Bill 2018. I lay a copy of the bill on the table.
Only some informations. I have to inform members that the Business Advisory Committee, in its meeting held on 2nd January 2018, has allotted the government legislative business as follows. Consideration and agreeing to the amendments made by the Lok Sabha in the Constitution 123rd Amendment Bill 2017 as passed by Lok Sabha as reported by the Select Committee of Rajya Sabha and has passed by Rajya Sabha with amendments 3 hours. Further consideration and passing of the National Commission of Backward Classes Repeal Bill 2017 as passed by Lok Sabha, both together 3 hours. Consideration and passing of the Motor Vehicles Amendment Bill 2017 as passed by Lok Sabha and as reported by the Select Committee of Rajya Sabha, 3 hours. Consideration and passing of the Muslim Women Protection Rights on Marriage Bill 2017 as passed by Lok Sabha, 4 hours. Now, special mention, only one has left, Tirusi Shiva.
Sir, the most common source of water supply. Sir, the most common source of water supply for the Indian agriculture sector are borewells, especially in the area where the rainfalls are scanty. Groundwater in India provides for largest irrigation source, which is 61.6%. Hence, it is important that the cost of drilling borewells must be considered for exemption from the GST framework. It is believed that there are about 10,000 rigs that operate within the country, which provide services to the agriculture sector and were exempted from the service tax earlier. The cost of each vehicle is about 1 crore and requires 5 to 6 workers. It's very difficult to predict the hours of work because of the seasonal nature of agriculture. And the cost of rigging is calculated starting...
Please, order in the house.
Mike is here. We can't hear you.
Mike is working now, sir.
Mike is working?
Yeah, normally. Yeah. I'll please start. Wait. It's very difficult to predict the hours of work because I think normally it's working. So the most common source of water supply for the Indian agriculture sector are borewells, especially in the area where the rainfalls are scanty. Groundwater in India provides for largest irrigation source, which is 61.6%. Hence, it is important that the cost of drilling borewells must be considered for exemption from the GST framework. It is believed that there are about 10,000 rigs that operate within the country, which provide service to the agriculture sector and were exempted from service tax earlier. The cost of each vehicle is about 1 crore and requires 5 to 6 workers. It is very difficult to predict the hours of work because of the seasonal nature of agriculture, and the cost of rigging is calculated according per feet of drilling done. In such a scenario, it will be very difficult for the rig operators to cover various responsibility of obtaining certificates of registration, amongst other things, for GST filling. Most of the rigs use diesel, which is kept out of the GST framework. If GST level on rigs levied on rigs, it will increase the cost for the farmers, which will be an added burden for them. Sir, I urge the government to exempt the drilling of borewell for water supply for agriculture from GST in the interest of the farmers in the country who rely solely on borewell for agriculture water supply. It will be immensely reduce their burden, as additional costs will be avoided. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, B. Matran. Dr. B. Matran, absent. Sri Sanjay Raut, absent. The House stands adjourned till 11 hours.